Hi everyone and welcome inside Forrester Glen Park. I'm Logan Hunt, alongside me joined by Justin Coleman. And today, Justin, we have the first ever live stream event for Huntington University Baseball as the Forresters are in the first round of the Crossroads League tournament, taking on the Bethel Pilots. Forresters ranked fourth, Pilots ranked fifth. It's a crucial game coming up for us today.
Yes, it is. Key to the game today, just get on base. Score's going to come to you later in the game. Don't need to rush it.
I said these two teams faced off twice in the regular season. The Forresters losing 11-0 at Bethel on April 26th, but then came back and won 5-3 in 10 innings, able to go the distance there against Bethel. As we take a look now at the Crossroads League standings, and this is how they stack up in the tournament. Taylor University, the top seed, 37-16 overall, 19-7 overall in the Crossroads League. And both Bethel and the Forresters faced Taylor as their last games. Bethel splitting with Taylor. Also, the Forresters splitting with Taylor with their last game coming off a win, a 4-1 over them. Second is Mount Vernon. Third, Spring Arbor. Forresters in fourth. Bethel in fifth. Iwu in sixth. Goshen in seventh. St. Francis 8th, Marion 9th, and Grace rounding out the top 10. Everybody in action today looking to get a win and try to move on. Now, this is a double elimination tournament, so it's not necessarily lose and go home.
That's good to hear, because from right now looking at the standings, it's going to be an even match.
So definitely a very even match on both teams, as we can see these two teams taking on just a really similar record. Forresters 19-26 overall. Bethel 18-23. Now the winner of this game will go on to play Monday at 3:30, and they will face the winner of Taylor and St. Francis. And so that game will be played at 3:00 as well today. And once again, the winner of this Forrester and Pilots game will face the winner of the Trojans and the Cougars at 3:30 on Monday. Now the loser will end up playing on Monday as well, but they'll play at 12:00, and they'll face the loser of the Taylor and St. Francis game, and you know, work their way down to the loser bracket and that side of the bracket in the Crossroads League tournament. So with baseball, you always have doubleheaders and the best team winning, and the Forresters have the work cut out for them, but have a bit of advantage here with the home field and on a beautiful Saturday afternoon.
That is true. It could be raining. You could be playing at Bethel, so you have the crowd with you. You have your family, your friends here watching you. Might as well go out there and get the big W today.
Say, this is definitely a big week here for the Forresters and for all the students here at Huntington University. Last week of classes already up, have finals week coming up, but at least the classes are out of the way and the Forresters can just focus on working their way through the Crossroads League tournament.
Ooh, that is good to say right there. Took the words out of my mouth. Back to Logan Hunt right there.
Say, they'll be playing here at 3:00. Once again, Forresters taking on the Pilots. We'll have coverage for you from the very beginning, as we're going to take just a quick break here right before we get the first pitch. We'll be back with more Forrester baseball when we return here on FDN Sports.
My name is James Parker, and I'm from Port Elizabeth,
South Africa. I'm majoring in exercise science under the Department of Kinesiology.
My name is Paris Williams, and my major is sports and exercise studies.
Our department really comes in two different areas. The exercise science area, which is interested in the medical aspects of exercise. And the other side of the department looks at recreation and sport management, which is a little bit more in the business and the administrative side of sport.
Growing up, my mother had a lot of difficulties maintaining a healthy weight. And then when I got older, I made it my goal to try and motivate her and help her. And in about a 2-year period, she lost almost 75 pounds. I just saw how her life became better, and I wanted to be able to do that for other people. So it started at home, and hopefully I can impact a lot more households.
I was an exercise science major, but when I got a job here as an athletic trainer, that kind of changed my mind, and that's what I wanted to pursue. So I changed my major to exercise and sports studies.
The professors and faculty go and take the extra step to commit to students and to influence their lives and really set time apart for us, which is great.
My relationship with faculty and staff here in this department is really fun and easygoing.
They'll chat to you if they see you, they'll come and talk to you, and they want to know where you want to go in life and how they can help you get there, more so than just helping you get an A in the class.
I think like most professors here at Huntington University, we're here because we want to have relationships with the students. We don't want to just come to class and teach for 50 minutes and then go home. We're interested in interacting with them personally and getting to know them.
All my classes, we all able to get direct feedback from the professors when we have questions.
You never feel like just a number in any of them. You actually get to know the professor. You never feel afraid to ask questions.
A lot of our classes are very hands-on. We put a lot of emphasis on developing those skills by actually having them do the skills and not just talking about them in the classroom.
We have the YMCA close by and Parkview Hospital that's really close by. And between the two, we get a lot of internship hours and get to actually practice what we learn about in the classroom.
We do blood pressure, skin fold tests. We get to do bod pod testing.
We have the bod pod, which is something that only a handful of schools in Indiana have, and the other schools are really big schools.
The university has been very good about making sure that we can have the latest and the best stuff in our lab so that we're testing students in stuff that they're going to see in the industry.
When you compare schools of our size against us, I'd say our resources are a lot better. The equipment we have is fantastic.
Post-graduation for our students is very strong. They end up going usually one of two ways, either into graduate school or into a position that is relevant to the field. If they've done their part here to work hard, to make sure they have good internship experiences, good recommendations, then they are very, very competitive in whatever they want to do after graduation.
I'll be graduating this May and I'm really excited to start working as a fitness and wellness coach at a corporate wellness center in Chicago.
After I graduate from here, I'll actually be going to Manchester University and I'll be going to their athletic training program to become an athletic trainer.
Welcome back down to Forest Glen Park. I'm Logan Hunt, Longstream, joined by Justin Coleman. And we're getting ready to start between the Foresters and the Pilots. Tanner Wise on the mound for the Foresters.
Ready to watch some baseball tonight.
Exactly.
It's a beautiful day. Got a good game. Let's get it started.
Wise on the mound, 3-7 on the year, win to loss, and giving up 5.9 ERA, coming up first. Bit high on the first pitch.
Gotta test your limits.
Up to bat for the Pilots, number 14, Zachary Foster, out in center field, the junior. You see Wise trying to work himself in a strike. Two balls here. First strike of the game. Foster slugging at a 2,500%. Gonna get a foul going out. Two balls, two strikes now for Wise.
He's playing it safe right now. Gotta keep him swinging.
Foster battling in the box. Starting for your Foresters, though, have Tanner Wise on the mound. Catching is Michael Crawley. See another foul tip there. Playing first is Shea Beecham. Out in second, Jamar Weaver. Shortstop, Dylan Hendricks. Playing third base, Adam Roser. Out in left field, DJ Moore. Center field, Brock Gower. And out in right, Dalton Combs.
Got the best lineup for the Forester out there right now. Big game comes from big lineup, big changes. Got to put it out there all game.
See Zach Foster getting hit with the pitch there, so he gets to take his base to first. So runner on first, no outs to start.
It's not how they need to start the game. Got to get the whole team hyped up with the first out. A walk is not what they needed this first batter.
Colin Affolder up to hit. Looking for a bunt. Gets a strike. Affolder hitting 260 on the season. Wise looking for the pickoff at first. Not there. Keeping the runner true, though. One strike. No balls. And got him out there. Nice job there from Crowley to Beecham. Getting Foster out.
slick play by the Foresters.
Had a ball there. Nice job picking them off, picking off the runner. One out now for the Foresters. One ball, one strike for Wise on the mound. And a strike there. Three umpires here today for this Crosswoods League matchup. We have Mike Mann, Kevin Faust, and Tim Wesley at the helms. We see a hit here. Boggled by Weaver, but still able to recover and get it to Beecham in time. Two down now for the Foresters.
Close, almost an error. He got lucky enough to pick it up and notice that it was right in front of him and pop it to first for the quick out.
Strike here from Wise. Up is Eric Kelver. Kelver leading the team, hitting 336, batting third. Gets his bat, and that's going to go out and foul. So two strikes, no balls, two outs for Tanner Wise here, top of the first. Hit down foul line to third, and Adam Roser gets it in cleanly to Beecham. Three up, three down for Tanner Wise and the Foresters. Hold the Pilots scoreless, top of the first. Changeover coming now with the Pilots and the Foresters. Out to pitch for Bethel. It's going to be Jared Laurent. Laurent pitched 61 innings for the Pilots, the most of any pitcher on the team. Has 38 Ks and giving up a 4.23 ERA, though, so definitely the Foresters are going to be looking to hit on the lefty.
Ooh, they kind of need to get some hits, get the bats swinging early. Right now, hits are like the key point right now, because right now, no one is hitting the ball. If the Foresters can get it, the ball out to at least outfield, they should be good for the day.
Up first for the Foresters is going to be Adam Roser hitting leadoff, followed by Jamar Weaver, then Shea Beecham. Dalton Combs in it at the four spot. Dylan Hendricks at the five. DJ Moore, followed by Mike Crowley. Then Adam Roser in at the DH hitting eighth. And Brock Gow rounding out the lineup hitting ninth. See the Foresters going to try to get some hot bats going here. Mentioned last time the Foresters were out here at Forest Glen. They lost to Taylor University in the doubleheader in the first time. They lost 4-3. Made a nice comeback after going down 4-0. Just couldn't quite complete the comeback and then ended up winning that night game 4-1 over the top-ranked Trojans in the Crossroads League. So we'll see if they can't try to get some runs here in on Laurent and the Pilots and try to start out the first inning right. Adam Roser hitting 329 on the season. Usually a sure hit into the gap. Taking the first strike here from Laurent. Second pitch hit by Roser. Taken by shortstop to first. That will be an out.
Quick out too. Only two throws to two pitches. I'm sorry. I'm slipping today.
So Weaver now out to hit. We saw McDonald have to make that stretch to get that out, but like the hustle from Adam Roser. Second pitch going to be outside. Two balls, no strikes for Jamar Weaver, the second baseman for the Foresters. Laurent, a very quick pitcher here. Throws way inside. Three balls here. Weaver being very patient in the box.
Take the walk over the hit any day. It's guaranteed.
First strike. Fourth ball coming there, wild pitch, and Jamar Weaver gonna trot over to first off the walk.
The nerves are up right now. Big game, the pitchers gotta go all out. And you see the stress going out right there, hitting the batter.
So definitely a stressful situation. Not lose and go home, but still start the Crossroads League. Both of these teams needing to win the tournament to make it to Nationals, and don't want their season to end quite so soon. Beecham up to hit. Hitting 341 on the season. Had to sit out a few games. The injured leg, he injured at the St. Francis game. But you know Beecham can really bomb. It has four home runs on the season.
Big boomer with the bat.
Had a two-run homer last match against Taylor. All right, they're on back to first. Weaver getting back safely. One strike. No balls, one out here for Laurent. Beecham getting his bat on it. Hitting that out in foul territory. Two strikes now for the big fella. Beecham getting his bat on it. See a missed opportunity there from Brookshire. Ball going right to second base. Couldn't quite make the play, so Weaver making it safely to second. Beecham making it to first.
It's not a home run, but we'll take it.
Hey, Brookshire's couldn't quite get his bat on it. Nice job there from Beecham, digging himself out of the hole. Way to battle and get it on base. Man on second, on first and second, excuse me. Dalton Combs up to hit.
That's normally the for sure out, but got lucky that he wasn't paying attention and caught him and get the error. Now he's on base.
Dalton Combs hitting 357 on the season. Also has five home runs. See him there as the cleanup guy hitting fourth. Laurent throwing ball on the first one. Strike there, just painting the corners on the outside, not making it easy for Combs.
Gonna have to stretch for it.
Cam Galloway behind the plate for the Pilots. Swing and a miss there from Dalton Combs. One ball, two strikes.
Getting antsy out there, trying to swing at anything that he sees.
Ball outside. Galloway taking it in the chest there. Two balls, two strikes. Ball outside. Nice eye there from Combs. Getting the full count.
This pitcher wants him to stretch for it. He's going to paint the corners all game in hopes that they'll try to swing at it. Definitely. Right now it's not working for him.
They definitely trying to throw away from the big hitter, Dalton Combs. Putting some down the middle. Combs with the hit. Drive out to right field. That's going to score Jamar Weaver. Here comes Beecham coming home at the plate. Safe. And Combs getting to third.
Big play for the Force. That's how you want to start the first inning right there.
Beecham looked to hurt his leg rounding home. That's why it was as close as it was. Big hit there from Dalton Combs, however.
Talk about stress at the beginning. Now it's even stressful since you fall behind 2-0 in the first inning. And it's kind of your fault on that one. Gave it right to him, right across the plate.
Combs with the triple, two RBI already. We mentioned off the full count. Laurent looking a bit rattled, one out. Hendricks looking to get Dalton Combs in, but Laurent throwing strike on the first pitch. Hendricks batting respectable 283 at the five spot. We see a hit to second. And that gets Dalton Combs in. Dylan Hendricks out, though. But getting the runner in, just like that, it's 3-0 in the bottom of the first. Forrester's rolling. Spend some time as the DH, and we see, looks like going to be a fly out to right field. And that's how the first inning will come to a close. Forrester's on top 3-0 over the Bethel Pilots. We'll be back with more Forrester baseball action when we return here from Forest Glen Park. Once again, this is FDN Sports.
Here at Huntington University. This is my 31st year here at the university. We feel like that we have a tradition, a reputation of doing things the right way. We really place a high emphasis on commitment, personal responsibility, playing the game the right way, work ethic. Those things are all really important in our program. We're looking for those guys that really want to come to Huntington University and be challenged in the classroom, be challenged with their faith in Christ and growing in that part of their life, and place a high value on their baseball development, wanting to be a part of a program that's special. And that's what we try to work at every day.
Save 7 cents on every gallon of fuel with the JJ's Excellence Card. Stop in at any JJ store and get yours.
Welcome back to the first pitch here of the second inning. Strike coming from Tanner Wise. Forster's on top 3-0. After the shot from Dalton Combs brought in Weaver and Beecham, and Hendricks able to bring Dalton Combs in. Big first inning there from the Foresters. Pilots looking for an answer. Brookshire up to hit, hitting 265 on the season. Ball just a little inside there.
Could have been a strike. It looked like it was a strike from where we are.
2-1 count for Brookshire. Strike coming from Wise.
Painted the corners. Back at it again.
And a strikeout for Tanner Wise. Caught Brookshire looking. Said throw it outside and just got himself over the plate.
Now batting the Bethel right fielder, number 9, Jesse Zapata.
Zapata now up to hit. Hitting 295. Ball a little high there for Wise. One out already for the Foresters. Pitch going outside there. Just couldn't quite bring that ball down in time.
Is that the second ball?
Yep. Strike inside there from Wise. Looking to even the count here. Three-one count. Zapata has taken a swing yet. Wise taking a little extra time here on the mound after that pitch. Zapata getting a bat on it. Weaver can't quite field it in time. And Cepeda able to run it out and get on base.
In college, you normally see that. That's a for sure out. But today, ground's a little jumpy. Ball's bouncing everywhere. Nothing's for sure guaranteed tonight.
Now we have Erla, the DH for the Pilots, hitting 333. Man on first, one out for the Foresters. Erla getting a hit between the gaps. Now we'll advance the runner to second. Erla getting himself on base. Two hits here now in a row for the Pilots. We had the catcher Galloway up to hit. Galloway hitting 259 on the season. Man on first and second, one out for Wise. Flips himself a fastball right down the gut.
After two hits in a row, that's what you need to see. Strike right over the plate.
Strike again there from Wise. Pitcher up in the count. Two strikes, no balls, one out. And a strikeout there for Wise. Three pitches. Galloway going to trot back to the dugout. Two outs now.
Now batting the first baseman, number eight, Nick McDonald.
Nick McDonald up to bat. The first baseman hitting 240. Strike there from Wise, looking good so far to start this match.
It's a nasty little curveball right there.
Wise taking a little more time on the mound than Laurent. See the pickoff coming, got him.
Ooh, that was beautiful. Faked him out enough to just get him.
Nice job there, picking off Cepeda on second. Weaver getting himself over there and doing a nice job. Get that third out. So Bethel left wondering, leaving men on base. Down 3-0, that's hard to do. So that's how top of the first ends. Out in the field now for the Pilots. Obviously you have pitching, you have Laurent. Catcher is Galloway. Playing first is McDonald. Second, Brookshire. Shortstop, Brannick. Third base is Kelver. Out in left field, Affolder. Center is Foster. And right field, Cepeda with Erlud as the DH. Lineup there for the Pilots.
Foster's got to jump on it now. They left three people on base. They got to find ways to bat them in. So they try to jump on it, get some hits, people on base. Hope for some home runs, too.
It'll be Mike Crowley, the catcher, coming up to hit, leading off this inning. Crowley struggled a bit this year, hitting 243. Really started out the year just kind of in a slump after finishing second in the Crossroads League MVP stand rankings. So, looking for, you know, trying to finish out the season on a high note for sure.
You got to. You can't go from second to just out the first round. You got to be up in the top championship. You can't go in the loser's bracket. You got to be championship bracket, winner's bracket all the way, then just hope for the best.
Foul there from Mike Crowley. 1-1 count. Bottom of the second. Crowley getting a clean hit there. And it's gone. Ooh. Home run there for Mike Crowley. Solo shot.
Did I just call that? Yeah, I did call it. Hey. Look at that. I want to call another one now. Good shot.
What a hit there. Bats are hot right now for the Foresters. Exactly what Mike Crowley needed.
Second in the MVP category right there. Bad chosen.
Sent that ball out to left. Just stayed fair for him. Beautiful shot. Coming up now for the Foresters, the designated hitter, excuse me, Andy Roser, batting at a 200. So, see what Andy Roser has.
Can we see another home run?
Never know. 4-0, Foresters on top. No outs here in the second. We'll see Roser get out on first. Nice throw there from Galloway.
Early swing, barely nipping the ball.
First out of the second inning for the Foresters. Brock Gower now up to hit. Hasn't had too many at-bats, only 94 at-bats, but hitting 372 on the season with two home runs.
Big boomer. Not enough. He's up to bat enough to get those hits. That's what you need. That's why he's the last hitter in the lineup right now.
They also a very good pitcher, top pitcher here for the Foresters. Like I said, can do both for you. One ball, one strike for Gower. So far, everything going the Foresters' way. Just a beautiful day of baseball, too. Had some, you know, some nasty weather here in Indiana recently. As we see Gower's hitting between the gap, that's going to get him to first base.
Nice. Man, a mini traits right there.
Yeah.
Can do everything. Pitch, hit, field, everything you think of, he can do.
Say, we definitely have had just some bad weather here, and glad to see now just actually good baseball weather. Feels like a nice baseball day on this beautiful Saturday.
That is so true. We've had rain the last few weeks. Literally every day of the week has been rain. So just to see the sun out, not that much wind, and then baseball, it feels like spring.
Back to the top of the lineup, Andy Roser, Adam Roser, little brother of Andy Roser, up to bat. One out, one strike here. Gower on first. Gower going to get back to first in time. Saw Roser try to put a bunt down off the first pitch, see if he tries it again here. Gonna get a shot out to left, and it's caught. Nice play there on left field by Avfolder. Just getting to it in time. Nice little slide.
Like it. It's the stuff you see on SportsCenter every night. Big plays like that.
Weaver now up to bat. Pitch going to be high. Two outs here. Bottom of the second. Foresters on top 4-0 so far. 1-0 count for Jamar Weaver, the second baseman for the Foresters, who had that nice pickoff there with Tanner Wise to get that third and final out.
Never going to forget that play. He faked me out, and I'm just watching.
Well, we talked about how Wise takes a lot more time on the mound than Laurent. And really, it kind of caught the pilot sleeping there. It's Beta trying to get too big of a run. Gower doing a nice job getting back there. Galloway looking for pickoff of him. Couldn't quite do it. 2-0 count. Weaver getting a bat on it. Sending that out in foul territory.
Wide right.
2-1 count now for Jamar Weaver. Battling in the box here. Again, see Laurent throwing Gower back. trying to keep him honest. Ball way inside at the feet of Weaver. It's a 3-1 count now.
Honestly, I would have tried to get hit by that pitch. It was right there. Literally, you just move your foot, it get hit, you're on base.
Once again, Laurent throwing back. He can't get himself out of this hole. Don't see anyone warming up. We see Weaver with a shot between in the gap. Going to be a single for him and Vance Gower to second. Nice hit there from Jamar Weaver.
Almost snagged it out the air. Would have been a beautiful play, too.
Shea Beecham now up to bat. Going to be a strike there on Beecham. Beecham got himself a hit last time there. Outside. And that's going to be out. Jamar Weaver going too far. And nice pickoff there to end the inning. Nice up there from Galloway. And that's how the second inning comes to a close. Forster's on top, 4-0 over the Pilots. We'll be back with more Forester baseball action when we return from Forest Glen Park. I'm Logan Hunt. Long's been joined by Justin Coleman, and this is FDN Sports.
Much like trying to appreciate literature or music for more than just an entertainment value, but also looking into the nuances of what makes a good piece of writing, what makes a good piece of music, what makes a song that moves you and is also technically interesting and that sort of thing. And so coffee has some of those same sort of textures to it. There's, you know, depending on where coffee comes from, depending on how it's roasted, depending on how it's prepared, there's all these different hands that touch the coffee and manipulate the coffee and move it, and you end up with this final product. And it started out as a living organism. It's an honorable trade, I think. It seems like a small thing, and it's different things to different people, but as far as appreciating what it is that I do, I take it very seriously and just kind of interact with the coffee.
Plans don't always go the way we want them to, but you're not alone in this adventure called life. Remedy Live is a non-for-profit web station that strives to produce a positive message while helping teens who need it. If we can.
And we're back here at Forest Glen Park. First pitch of the third, and McDonald up to bat gets a nice hit out to center. Only going to be a single, though. Nice bit of fielding there from the Foresters.
I wasn't expecting that right out the gate. Just boomer to deep center field.
It's exactly what McDonald and the Pilots needed, however, though. Needed a nice hit. Get themselves going down 4-0, top of the third.
They needed the confidence too, because bats have been weak right now. That's a big hit, so maybe the Pilots are going to jump on that hit and start scoring.
Brannick up to bat, hitting 245.
Skyscraper.
Fly out there, Gower with the hit, or with the grab, excuse me. Hold McDonald there on first. Zach Foster now, back up to hit, top of the lineup for the Pilots. Foster was hit by a pitch in the first, then was picked off. So we'll see what he has here. Ball going outside. Wise doing a nice job on the mound here, only giving up two hits so far. Strike coming inside on Foster. 1-1 count. Outside pitch. Going to be 2-1 now for Tanner Wise. Strike inside again from Wise. 2-2 count. One out. Foster looking to get something going here for the Pilots. Had a tough time hitting so far.
They need it. Confidence on that team's really low right now.
Foul there from Foster, just getting his bat on it. Foster have to be aware of possibly turning a double play here. One out, man. Runner on first. Henrik's getting it to second. Not going to get there to first, though. Foster able to get himself down, but McDonald going to be thrown out at second. Nice play there from Dylan Henrik's.
He almost called another thing today. I don't know how he's doing it. First the home run, then almost the double play. You want to predict the Super Bowl next year?
I tell you what, if I could do that, that would definitely be something. Two outs here, top of the third for the Foresters. Up 4-0 here on the Pilots. Up to bat, left fielder Affolder made that nice grab, and Henrik's able to get it there to Weaver off the hit, and he will retire the Pilots. So now we're joined here by a special HU alum. We have Blake Holbein here with the closer for the Foresters last year. Blake Holbein, how does it feel to come back here and watch these Foresters play in the conference tournament?
Well, great. It's great to be here, Logan. Thanks for having me. And, yeah, it's awesome. It's been cool to see what they've been doing this season, and great to be back here and see some of these former teammates of mine. And, yeah, I'm just honored to be here.
How many games have you been able to come back and see? Are you still living around the area?
Yeah, I am around the area. I've actually not been able to be back to see any games, but I have kept up with the email updates and looked at some of the stats online throughout the season. So it's been cool to follow these guys from there.
So far, you like what you see from these Foresters taking the Pilots?
Yeah, they're looking good. We were just out there in the outfield for the first couple innings watching, and looking good. Tanner starting off, getting things going, you know, a little rough with the first walk, but got over that, you know, nice shot down to first from Crowley in that first inning, and since then, they haven't really looked back.
What exactly was your favorite memory here from Huntington? Push it down to your senior year. Just your senior year. What was your favorite senior year memory?
On this field, that's interesting. There's a lot over the years. So I guess last year, I'm not sure. I don't know. On this field, I'm not sure what I'd say for on this field, but I know, I guess, last year down in Florida, some of those games, those were a lot of fun. So it's pretty cool to see the whole field set up here, though. A nice shot there.
That's gone.
Beecham, and that is gone. You're right. Wow. Cranked it. That's two bombs already.
Yeah. Nice solo shot there from him. It's like he was trying to raise Crowley. I think that home run ball went maybe just a bit deeper there than Crowley. Just a bit deeper.
A little bit more in the alley there. Crowley's was pretty much a straight shot down the line. So, yeah, we'll give him the distance on that one.
5-0 so far here from the Foresters, and got to think Coach Frame likes what he sees so far. And speaking of that, what was probably your best encounter, best like teaching moment from Coach Frame?
I would say, you know, probably a lot dealing with the mental side of the game, working from the mound. It's interesting, really, because a lot of times as a pitcher, you don't work as much directly with the head coach as you do the pitching coach. But, really just dealing with the mental side and working batters. And a nice shot from Combs in the gap. Doesn't get down.
Foster able to come over there and make the play on center. Had to get on the wheels, though.
Yeah.
Combs had that nice shot out to right earlier. Brought in Beecham and Weaver.
Yeah, that was a nice shot down the line. They're really working the whole field of play here, huh?
Definitely seems like it so far.
I was hoping for back-to-back bombs there. He's got the power to do it. Seen it plenty of times. So
they now tied with Beecham. Both have 5 home runs on the season. Really been lighting it up. Forster's with 16 total home runs. And definitely have some heavy hitters on this team.
Yeah. These guys can put it out of the park. And when you get some lefties, too, with some power like Combs, when you're working with a little bit of a shorter right field, obviously the wall's a little bit higher, but they'll get those home runs up, and it's always good to see your offense generating some runs like that.
Now, you played here last year, saw some of the new perks to playing on the field, so I had a few new things, but not the whole thing.
Yeah.
You know, how are you liking Forest Glen Park now?
It is looking sweet. I tell you what, I was just talking with Bryce Urschel, one of my former teammates as well, and he was just saying, you know, how this thing is looking sweet. I mean, I think without a doubt, we can say with confidence this is the best field in the conference.
Oh, yeah, this is definitely a lot of money going into it. Not quite done yet. A few more tweaks here and there. Going to see a few more renovations going on. But I got to say, from being here in the press box, definitely pretty nice.
And I got to say, too, you guys are doing a great job with this up here. I mean, the broadcasting, it is going on. So, hey, I mean, if we could have people up here to see this, I'd love it. I mean, we got the couches. We got the trophies up here. We got – what is this place?
Say we got all
running a minor league system here. Come on.
Definitely have all the hardware up here. Forster's so far starting out strong, looking to possibly bring some hardware back.
Nice shot up the middle there.
Freshman DJ Moore been hitting well all year long. Okay. Mentioned he got thrown in there as the DH for a while and hasn't upset, hitting 300 on the season.
Wow, impressive.
Crowley mentioned had that solo shot out to the left earlier, second at bat.
All right, here's a guy I know. You know, I got to say, so Crowley, you know, caught me last few years. Great to have him. It's always, you know, it's always cool as a pitcher to get used to different guys. But I got to say, Crowley, it was cool. I had the opportunity to play with him in Niagara Falls over the summer on the Niagara Power. That was pretty cool. So we actually got to go from that summer into last year's season playing together all year. And it's been cool to see him excel. Even with last year, I don't know if you guys know this, but he was dealing with some serious back issues. So to see him recover and playing at the level that he plays at, it's fun to watch.
Zane still finished second in the MVP voting for Crossroads Player of the Year.
Wow.
I mean, still was up there and doing his thing. It's definitely Mike Crowley, a leader on this team.
Gets jammed a little bit there.
Third and final out there for the Foresters in the bottom of the third. We're going to take a quick break here. We change to the fourth. Foresters on top 5-0 here at Forest Glen Park. Logan Hunt joined by me, Blake Holbein, nice alum, able to come back. We'll be back here on FDN Sports.
My name is Ted Rankin. I like music and various video games of sorts, and definitely I'm always down for a good game of Pokemon of all different varieties. I'm a biblical studies major with the youth ministry minor, and I want to go into that to be a youth pastor and to be able to help grow like teenagers and middle schoolers as they grow throughout their high school careers. The main thing is I like being able to be here to help people out, like to help solve the issues and to provide from the different ways, and especially like the freshmen as they come here and have to be in a new place. I like being able to be there for them and to watch them as they grow and build.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Save 7 cents on every gallon of fuel with the JJ's Excellence Card. Stop in at any JJ's store and get yours.
Welcome back to Forest Glen Park. I'm Logan Hunt. Longs me to have Blake Holbein. And before we go any further in this broadcast, I have to thank Derek Zerker, our director, coming back. Had himself an internship with the Charlotte Hornets. Anybody that's followed FDN Sports knows it's been a big part of what's gone on here. And I have to thank him for coming back and getting this one baseball game in for us. So thank you, Derek Zerker, as well as we see Wise getting ready to get going again. Hasn't given up a run yet. See, that ball
looks might like stay in, and it does.
Beecham making the catch. Kelver flying that one out. Mitch Kelver batting 336 for the Pilots. Just hasn't quite had things go his way.
That's a great job by Tanner. Trying to keep that pitch count low, getting that first guy early. Hey, we'll take pop flies in foul territory all day. Easy outs. Easy out for Beecham there.
Berkshire now up to bat for the Pilots, second baseman.
Wise is really working away right now, and it seems to be working for him. He's getting some ground balls, getting some little dinker pop flies, and hopefully he can keep working it. I mean, yeah, it's good to see Goose Eggs up there as a defense. Yeah.
Collins making the grab out right field.
Yeah, nice, easy pop fly, another one there. Again, keeping that pinch count low. I think that's maybe only 4 pitches or so for this inning. So,
yeah. So you mentioned Wise struggling throughout the year, really only 3 wins starting pitcher, but really turned it on here late, and it's kind of morphed into that pitcher we saw last year from him, really dialing up.
Yeah, I mean, it's great to see him get going here when it's, you know, it's game time. It's tournament time. You got to play your best. So, hey, obviously, you know, he'd hope for better during the season, throughout the whole season. But look at that. Boom, there's another out. 1-2-3 inning. Looking good.
Say that. That's exactly what you look for the Forcers. Playing 9 innings here in the Crossroads League, different from your typical 7. It's definitely going to need Wise to go the distance here. And without his pitching, I don't see why not. See the change coming. Laurent still on the mound for the Pilots, giving up 5 runs though. We'll see how long the Pilots decide to stick with him. The Forcers can't maybe get a few more runs on the board.
Yeah, they've made Laurent pay a little bit. Seems like he's been having a little bit of control issues. He's not a guy that with a lot of velo. He's, you know, kind of tries to backdoor some of these curveballs, it looks like. Gets a little bit of movement going. Forcers are really making him pay from what it looks like so far. So we'll get underway here.
Yeah, so we'll see what Andy Roser can do. DH stepping up to the plate for the Foresters, and so far everything going Huntington's way. Bottom of the fourth, 5-0, Forsters on top.
See if he can redeem himself here. I believe he had a little slow grounder, almost like a swinging bunt on the last one. So I know he's got the power and he's got a great stroke. It'd be great to see him lead this inning off with a nice hit.
First strike there for the rent. Oh, it's nice getting ahead of the count. Second one a bit high there. Nice eye there from Andy Roser. Who really, he's kind of had to find himself as a hitter throughout the season. We've seen him and Crowley share some time as a catcher, but both big hitters for the Foresters.
All right. Roser's in a good spot now. 2-1 count. You see him really, he's choking up quite a bit on that bat right now. I don't recall if that's a norm for him or, oh, that's going to go foul.
Yeah.
Well, it must be working because that was a long shot. If he can keep that thing fair, that's going to be another bomb for the Foresters.
Well, you saw he definitely had the power there, just pushed it a little wide.
Oh, yeah.
Like you mentioned, choking up on the bat must not be a bad thing for him.
No. I mean, hey, you know, obviously that last at-bat, he's making some in-game adjustments. You know, just put the bat on the ball, it's going to go. He's got the swing to make it go away. So, yeah, you can see the left fielder out there now. He's really been pushed back.
Not sure that's going to get through there. Clean play there as Rose are going to get thrown out. Going to first. One out for the Foresters. We'll see Brock Gower rounding out the lineup, see what he has. Got himself a single the first time.
Yeah. Brock's been looking good. I mean, I read one of the reports from the other day, and oh, unlucky for Brock there. Is a great play over there by number 11.
Definitely a great play there from Kelver playing third base. Not too often you see that play made.
No, yeah, it's a great diving play. But, yeah, Brock had a game. He went 5-for-5 the other day. I mean.
While pitching, I believe.
Does it get any better than that? I don't think it does, so.
We see now little Roser up to bat. Adam Roser, younger brother of Andy.
Yeah.
That ball's not going to get through. Third out there.
That's a tough pitch to hit there. I don't know if that's really a hitter's pitch. Curveball away. Got him to chase and just pounded into the ground. But, yeah, hats off to the pitcher there getting through. Kelver.
Yeah, we're going to take a quick break here from Forest Glen Park. Once again, I'm Logan Hunt. Longs to be joined by Blake Holbein, and this is FDN Sports.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Save 7 cents on every gallon of fuel with the JJ's Excellence Card. Stop in at any JJ store and get yours.
I'm Mike Wanis. I'm the Academic Dean at Huntington University. We are very excited about the Institute for Agricultural Studies and for the new program in agribusiness. Agriculture in Indiana is huge. It's a huge part of the economy. There's a lot of people involved. There's so many different levels of participation from farming all the way up, you know, through all the different kinds of agribusiness. And with our Christian mission, I think that we can bring a unique contribution in that area because we can look at agriculture and we can look at agribusiness, not just as how can we maximize profits, but how are we being good stewards of God's creation? How are we serving humankind, humanity through.
Welcome back here for the first pitch of the fifth. We see Erla able to slide that ball down the left base line, and looks like he's going to get himself a double. Nice hit there from the DH. Had a single last time and going to get himself a double now and just working his way up.
Now batting the Pilots catcher, number 22, Cam Galloway.
Yeah, that's a nice hit for Erla there. That's what they need to get a little spark here. They just had a shutdown inning, trying to get some runs on the board and make this game interesting.
Wise. Maybe could have had Erla there. There's no one.
Yeah, Erla better. You better be careful. Wise had that nice pickoff earlier.
Yeah, got Cepeda for that third out. Shot out to the left.
Erla tags. And he'll stay.
Nice throw there from Dalton Combs getting it there quick.
Now batting number 8, the first baseman.
We'll see McDonald now coming up. He had a single out to center. See what he can do in this try. 5-0, Foresters still on top of the fifth. about halfway through this nine-inning match. McDonald, not a terribly strong hitter, hitting 240 on the season.
Yeah, not one of those guys that really hits for average, but definitely hits for power. If he puts a bat on it, it's going to go.
Pitch nice, outside.
Nice stop by Crowley there. Really got his hips around it. Kept it in. It's just amazing. He does a great job of blocking the ball. I mean, that's one thing as a pitcher. When you can have confidence to really just let the ball go, throw it where you want to throw it, and he's going to do a good job of keeping it in, that's great. Because, I mean, you know, I tell you what, I've played with a lot of different guys, and if you're holding back as a pitcher and you can't feel like you can throw the ball, you're going to run into trouble. So now it's great to see. So, yeah, here's Tanner. He's back to a 1-2 count. Even after throwing that ball, that seemed a little bit wild.
Like you mentioned, 1-2 count here for Tanner. Had himself a nice game so far. Really has been in control the whole way. He's got some help from his hitters as well. Forster's really taking care of business so far. Cruising against the Pilots. Shot right there, caught by Weaver, and safe there. Erlai able to get back.
Great play by Weaver, man.
Yeah.
Thought they were going to get him a second.
Now batting the shortstop, number two. Austin. Two outs now for Wise and the Foresters. Brannick now coming up. Shortstop for the Pilots. Hitting 245 on the year. Shot out to the left side. That's going to float to the foul. See the sun starting to hide behind the clouds now. Here at Forest Glen Park. And start getting maybe a little chilly with that breeze.
Yeah, I tell you what, I was up in Fort Wayne today and we had a little bit of a few rain showers there, but it's been nice. It's holding off today. It's been a beautiful day. I don't know if you could get any better for baseball.
So we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, it really feels like the Indiana weather has been in full effect. You know, you had sun, then rain, then, you know, it went from the 60s to the 40s and just had some bad days for baseball. And this really feels like the first true day the Foresters have played here at home where you've had just nice baseball weather.
Well, Wise working with a 1-2 count here. Or
shot to center.
And they're going to hold him at third.
Nice hit there from Brannick, keeping the inning alive here for the Pilots.
Yeah, nice hit for Brannick. Now they're back to the top of their order here. They're going to see if they can get something out of this with two outs.
Here comes Foster. Just needs himself a base hit here to bring in Erla. Sitting at third.
Yeah, Erla, you know, I thought maybe they might try to send him there, but probably a good decision by the coach to keep him at third here with the top of your order coming up. Have some confidence to make something happen. But, yeah, I mean, kind of a shallow fly ball that dropped in there. Gower, you don't want to test his arm strength. He's a pitcher, too. He's got a great arm. Don't want to challenge that one, so good decision.
Pass made in time there. Throw, excuse me, made in time. Nice job there from the Foresters, getting Foster out. And that's how top of the fifth goes down. Foresters able to hold the Pilots off just a little bit longer. As now coming up on this lineup, we're going to see Jamar Weaver, Shea Beecham, also Dalton Combs getting into the bulk of the lineup for the Foresters. expecting maybe some more hits so far for the Foresters. We see Laurent still out on the mound for the Pilots.
Yeah, let's see if we can get some more runs going here. That was a great backhand play by Roser down the line. Hopefully carry some momentum into this inning and get some more runs.
Jamar Weaver so far has been walked. Also had a single through the gap and had himself so far a nice game, even defensively as well. Forced to playing very sound baseball.
Ah, Jamar. Love playing with Jamar.
Hey, it's one of the few starting freshmen last year for you guys. Add a little youth to the lineup.
Yeah, for sure. It was funny. I mean, I remember my junior year watching him play basketball in the state championship game and just thinking, this kid's a great athlete. We're picking up a good player here. I haven't even seen him play baseball, but you can just tell, you know, when somebody's able, I think, personally, if somebody's able to play multiple sports and be athletic at all of them, I mean, that's when you know.
Jamar with the shot out to center there.
There it goes.
Able to fly through and get himself a double. Nice hit there from Jamar.
Ooh. Great shot. Right in the right alley, pumping it out there, going with the ball, going with the pitch. Nice hit.
Talked about getting some more hits with this lineup, and that's exactly what it has been. You talked about Jamar Weaver getting to the state championship game there with Westview High School.
Yeah.
Definitely up there in Shipshawana. Just a really a nice place. Kind of a, I don't want to say the whole town, a little kind of antique.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you got to get out there and get your antiques. I know my mom and grandma like to go down there, you know, spend a nice little weekend.
Get some great furniture there, too. Got to say. Always good at making good stuff there. And that Westview team was a strong team as well. I really had some big guys for being a small class in basketball as well.
Yeah. Really. Yeah, Beachy. Well, actually, Beachy didn't play basketball with them. I know he cheerled them on to victory. But, yeah, they had a great team. Fun to watch.
See Jamar now having success here on the baseball side. Shea Beachum up to bat.
Ooh.
Weaver getting back in time. 1-2 count here for Beachum.
They're trying to keep him close there at second.
Had himself a home run last at bat. Saw that shot out to the left. See what he can do now.
Nice.
Not going to quite sneak it through.
Well, from here it looked like there was a little more power on it, but I guess it just kind of got under it and floated that a little bit. If that would have dropped in, that would have been, I think we might have been looking at a run there as the outfielders were playing so deep and shifted actually quite a bit to the left.
So you saw Brookshire there for the Pilots making the play. And I agree with you. I think Jamar could have got on the wheels there and made it in, but we'll see Combs now up to bat. Getting that nice tournament mustache going as well.
Gotta love the postseason facial hair. You know, get creative, have fun with it, but, you know, it's winning time at the same time here. Well, two straight curveballs here. He's not going to give Combs anything to hit, it looks like. He's really just trying to work him away. Here's another one. Combs can't quite beat it out.
Nice job there from Laurent getting over. Want to say that bad hit from Combs. Hendricks coming up now for the Foresters. Hendricks 0 for 2 on the day. Looking to get himself on base.
Yeah, hopefully he can squeak one through here, get a run in. Get his confidence back up.
We've seen Laurent slow down his pitching as well. And at the beginning, he was going very quickly and seemed kind of settle in.
There it is. Boom.
Yeah, there's that hit for
good shot, Dylan.
Getting Jamar Weaver and also from third, so nice. RBI there for Dylan Hendricks. Got Dalton Combs in that first inning and bringing in Jamar Weaver here in the set, or excuse me, in the fifth.
Offense looking good from the Foresters. I like what I see. If they keep hitting like this, we're looking at a good run in the tournament.
Some of the Foresters are going to have. They're looking to make nationals as well. It's been a tough year, really, for the Foresters.
Beautiful.
We're going to see Hendricks go. Thought he was going to go for third, instead gets stopped.
That was a great hit. Take what they give you.
Say, DJ Moore, that freshman, really has impressed a lot of people this year with his hitting, and that's ultimately got him into the lineup. Came in really as a pitcher and could do both in high school, but really his hitting is what got him going.
Yeah, I'm impressed. I haven't seen him play before today, and just from hearing about him as a pitcher and stuff coming in. But, yeah, he's doing a great job hitting the ball, making things happen here for the Foresters.
See a pitching change now for the Pilots. Saw Laurent take a seat, and looks like it's Logan Wagler, another lefty, up throwing for the Pilots. So Laurent gonna go take a seat after giving up six runs through five, and Logan Wagler, the freshman lefty pitcher, has some work to do so far. Laurent kind of put him in a hole here. What's the mindset of a pitcher coming up when you're down like this, Blake?
Yeah. Well, first I'll say this is kind of an interesting move by the Pilots. I would think they'd try to bring someone else in here that would maybe be one of their main guys. But yeah, I mean, coming in here, you know, you're down 6-0, bottom of the fifth. Really, you're just trying to get out of this. You know, you have two outs right now. You're just trying to get a ground ball out. You got guys on first and second. Get out of this inning. Get to hit. See if you can put some runs up on the board and then come back in and just give it your best shot, really. I mean.
Yeah, Wagler coming in now to this. He was 4-3 as a starter. Get 4.8 ERA and only pitched 45 innings, though.
Okay.
You know, like
okay.
You said. It's done had a little work. Freshman looks like
Wow. Well,
nice
I apologize to Mr. Wagler. I guess I figured. A lot of times as a freshman you don't get that many innings. So he's obviously doing a pretty good job this season.
Gonna come in here to the fifth with first batter gets to be Mike Crowley. I'm not sure I'd want to walk into that, but two outs, runner on second here for the Foresters. Or excuse me, runner on first and second for the Foresters.
Yeah, that's something you really want to walk into here. Crowley feeling it lately. We'll see what he can do. Ooh.
First pitch going to be a ball here for Wagler.
Crowley about wore that one.
Got to think, not too much pressure here for Wagler as well. I mean,
oh, man. That's
wore that one too, but. I guess the nerves are always going to get to you in a, you know, conference game. I would think, you know, being down 6-0, I don't have too much to lose here. Don't want to obviously increase the hold, but got two outs.
Yeah, I'm sure he's nerved up a little bit here. I mean, this is his first conference appearance. Trying to get out of this. That's three straight inside to Crowley.
Maybe not a bad idea, though. I'm just going to walk Crowley. I mean, load the bases up. You got, I believe, Andy Roser on deck here.
Not that I'm picking off signs or anything, but pretty sure Coach Thad framed on there gave him a take. So, there's the take, and he'll take his walk.
Bases loaded here. And see what Galloway's saying here with Wagler. So now we're going to see Mike Crowley getting on base, so going to be rewarded. Going to go sit down, and TJ Lindstrand going to make his first appearance of the day. Going to be running for Mike Crowley. Andy Roser.
All now right. Up. Yeah.
0-2 on the day. Could get himself a big hit here.
Yeah, he can definitely take advantage of Wagler here. Wagler's struggling. If he can get a... All right, he's seen a strike now. He should be ready to go because you got to know Wagler's just trying to get some strikes over the plate after four straight to Crowley. So if he can get a good one here, we might be see something leaving the park.
Getting his bat on it now, 0-2 count. Wagler right where he wants to be.
Yeah, good job by Wagler there. He kind of got Roser to chase one a little bit away. Gets far ahead in the count.
Another foul coming from Roser. I like the willingness to swing, though, from him. Still 0-2. After that big first inning for the Foresters, got three runs on the board, capitalized since, up 6-0, bottom of the fifth. Once again, with this being a crossroads tournament game, go through 9 innings. Tanner Wise not giving up a run yet, only giving up 4 hits so far. Rose getting his bat on it. That's going to bring in Hendricks, and we see Moore going for home. Bad throw, and that's going to advance Lindstrand and also Roser. Two runners getting in there, and a nice job for the Foresters.
Yeah, you can just feel the energy right now. They're feeling it. Guys are stringing some hits together. Great hit there by Roser. Tagging on a couple more RBIs.
Andy Roser sitting at second. TJ Lindstrand at third. Brock Gower up to hit, 2 outs. Bottom of the fifth, 7-0. Foresters on top of the Pilots. Third at bat here for Gower.
Well, Bethel's in trouble. I mean, you're down 8-0 now. Wagler's struggling here. I'm sure they were hoping he'd be able to kind of shut down the Foresters, but there's another high one, and they're probably just thinking, get to this next game, see what they can do. I feel like at this point, I mean...
Here's the thing also. I don't see anyone, warming up in the bullpen for the Pilots as well.
Yeah.
It's like they're just going to stick with Wagler here, at least to finish the inning. Say 8-0 off of 10 hits here.
Oh.
Gower fly out there to center field, and that's how the fifth inning will come to a close with the Foresters on top 8-0. And Pilots with their work cut out for them heading into the sixth inning. I'm Logan Hunt. Also, we have been joined by Blake Holbein. Blake, thank you for coming back here, and I really appreciate it. And we'll be back with more Forster baseball here on FDN Sports when we return.
It's extremely prevalent in the movies we watch, the music we listen to, or the lives that we got. But I'm not talking money, lust, or something as simple as those. I'm talking self-indulgence, greed, and pride which need exposed. From the very beginning dealing with Adam and Eve, someone told us a lie and straight up made us believe that we're so very important and ever so clean, that our lives are so necessary and that we establish the peace. That I'm the status quo and it's not you, it's me. Well, they forgot to mention that this life ain't glee. It's not about you and I, and it ain't about protecting me. It's not the clothes we wear or the makeup on your cheek. It can't be the number of touchdown points scored or successes with those beautiful feet, and it most definitely isn't the money that we got in the pocket of our jeans.
Welcome back here, Forrester. Glen Park, where so far it's been all Huntington taking care of business at home. Tanner Wise on the mound and looking very strong, Justin Coleman.
Yes, he has. He's pitching like it's the brand new game. First inning, he's never stopped.
Hit going out right side. Dalton Combs able to make the grab there. Affolders couldn't quite get enough boot behind him. One out. In the sixth.
The Pirates hope he lost it in the sun, but the sun went behind the clouds, so it's kind of hard to do that now.
8-0, Forrester's on top, and not looking to give out any more ground here.
I wouldn't plan on them to do that. They're up 8-0 in the sixth. Might as well put your foot on their throat and just end the game.
Hit there, we see Hendricks making the play. Kelver couldn't quite get behind it. Now batting the second baseman, number 15. Two outs here, top of the sixth. Two runners on up.
Forces made it like it's elementary baseball out here. Shouldn't be this easy to win a game, especially in the playoffs.
Sometimes it's your day, you know, sometimes it's not, and so far I would say it has definitely been the Foresters' day. And we know when these two teams met early in the season at Bethel, the Pilots took care of the Foresters 11-0, but then, you know, Huntington came back and won in 10 when they won 5-3, and this is just one of those games where I'm sure if they played twice, the second one would be a lot closer.
Has to be closer. You learned a little bit about the team the first game. Might as well jump on it.
Up here to bat, Brookshire, second baseman. And see Wise slipping it inside there. Ball going a bit wide there. 2-2 count now for Tanner Wise.
He has enough room to have little errors now. They're up by so much with little time left for them to come back, so he can do whatever he wants, basically. Shot straight out the center to Brock Gower for the easy out.
Saying that's how that will end for the Pilots, as Gower making the play, and now coming up into the lineup, we're gonna see the Foresters trying to capitalize on a big three-run inning. It'll be top of the lineup with Adam Roser, Jamar Weaver, and Shea Beecham all now up to bat. So we'll see what they can do. We're going to keep Wagler on the mound as well.
I would keep him out there. He just came in. He's got to get a little warmed up. You can't expect him to come out the bullpen throwing strikes.
Yeah, lefty looking to keep going here and see what the Pilots see if they don't try warm up anyone in the bullpen. It's still a long way to go. A couple more innings since we're playing 9 innings.
Isn't it normally 7 for college?
It is. Usually we've seen the CrossFit League. They've played two, you know, back-to-back doubleheaders, 7 innings. But now with this being the tournament, they're only going to do one 9 inning.
They went big lead is what you're telling me then.
Coming up here, going to be Adam Roser, bottom of the sixth. Adam Roser so far had some trouble hitting here and there, had a couple ground outs, but got himself one good hit. 1-for-3 on the day. This one going down the first baseline, and that will be out for Adam Roser.
It's been a rough day for him. His bat's not just doing the work tonight.
saying usually he is a sure shot as well. Jamar Weaver, though, got himself a double on his last at bat, looking to continue it. His Forster's going up and down their lineup. It seems like up 8-0 off of 10 hits so far.
The Foresters woke up and had their Wheaties is what it sounds like.
First pitch strike there for Wagler. Second one on its way. Doesn't quite get down. Seen a very consistent strike zone as well from the umpire.
Yeah, he's not changing it at all. Surprising. Depending on height, they normally change it, but they're not going to do it today.
Ball way inside. 2-1 count now for Jamar Weaver. Weaver with a hit out to right.
It's going to stay in or go foul?
And just going to be foul.
Into the wall.
Zapita couldn't quite get there in time. Looking a little shaken up on the play, running into that foul wall.
He ran into that for full speed. It looks like it really hurt him.
Looks like Pot's going to check on him, make sure he's all right. Looks to be staying in the game, should be okay. 2-2 count here for Jamar Weaver. Two-two count here, still for Weaver. Wagler still pitching away.
Painting the edges, always. That's what they're aiming for right now.
Full count. Weaver getting his bat on it out to center. That's going to be good for a single from the second baseman, Jamar Weaver. Staying hot.
Told you, when the bats are on, they're on. There's no stopping them. It's home run, single, or fly out. Either way, you're getting the bat on the ball. And that eventually stuff's going to fall for you.
Shea Beecham now. Up for the Foresters.
Try for the pickoff at first. Was a little too slow.
Yeah, I wasn't going to get him there. Strike there.
Right over the plate with the curveball. I would have took a swing at it, personally. I'd have tried to rip it up. But that's the me. They know what they're doing out there.
Beecham getting his bat on it. See if this one
is going to stay
going
in.
Back. And just hits the net.
So close.
O-2 count here. Beecham in a hole.
And here comes the sun again. Indiana weather, I'm telling you. Don't know what to do with it.
One out here, one on. On first base there, Jamar Weaver. That ball's down, and that's going to fly behind the catcher, Galloway, and Weaver getting safely to second.
Just got to drive him in now. He's already on second. It's easy to make him score from second than first. All you got to do is find the gap, and he probably scores. You're up 9-0. Is there a mercy in conference play? Or nope. Wow.
Ball outside. 2-2 count. Shea Beecham in there battling. One out with Jamar Weaver on base. Send that second. High hit there from Shea Beecham out into center. It's going to be caught by Foster for the second out in the sixth.
Good awareness to not losing the sun, especially with the sun coming, like playing hide and seek with us today. It's really hard to lose it.
See what Dalton Combs has. Had that big hit in the first. Brought in two runs. Big triple for himself. We'll see what he can do now in the sixth. Forces up 8-0. Two outs. One on. Wagler looking much better this inning than the last. And that's going to hit Dalton Combs. So Combs going to trot to first base. And just like that, we'll see Dylan Hendricks back up to bat.
They'll take that over the hit, though. But that was a really quick at bat. He literally walked up there, got ready, then off to first. Quick one for him.
Well, we saw Hendricks get himself on the board. Last at bat, singled out to left field, got himself an RBI. So, got to think a hit here, could score Jamar Weaver. Forced with 11 hits so far, both teams one error apiece, and really has it's just been the Foresters' day. They've come to play. That ball not going to slide through, and third and final out will be made against Dylan Hicks. And a beautiful play there, really.
It was a close play at first. I'd say
third baseman there. Kelver really doing his job and able to get it to McDonald in time. So that's how the sixth inning will come to a close now. Foresters on top 8-0. We'll be back with the top of the seventh when we return here on FDN Sports.
Taylan Halderman, and I'm the lighting designer here at Huntington University. I got into lighting actually high school in my junior high year. Seventh and eighth grade, you know, was just asked nonchalantly to do some lighting for the choir concerts at my high school. And, you know, I jumped behind the lighting console and that kind of sparked my love for it. And I've been doing lighting ever since. So I guess being a lighting designer really lets me creative release, really. I mean, I see things different than other people, but you know, when I look at something, how can that be lit differently in a way? How can it be lit artistically? Love the whole creative process from going to, okay, you know, what are we lighting? Concert? Is it a theatrical production? Is it a church event? And going from that to the finished product and seeing it all come together, kind of mind-boggling, really. But you know, it just makes me proud to be a part of that. So.
My name is Tori Stogdale. I'm a sophomore transfer student from Greenwood, Indiana. I transferred to Huntington University because I really like the whole Christian atmosphere. My boyfriend lives here and I'm rooming with my best friend of 17 years and I couldn't ask for anything better. Before I moved to Huntington, me and my boyfriend were having a long...
Now the seventh inning. Wise still on the mound for the Foresters. Hasn't given up a run yet. It's paid up to hit. And Cepeda struggled a little bit here. His last at bat kind of grimed out. And when he did get on base, when he got himself a double, I got picked off eventually. So that was a nice play made by Jamar Weaver early in the game.
I think we might see a pitching change because I've seen multiple pitchers up and pitching in the bullpen.
I say, Wise definitely getting up there in the pitch count. I know usually a full game for these guys, seven innings, and we're about here, so I got to think Wise. As long as he does his job here, he'll probably finish out this inning at least. He's paid to getting a hit out there to right in opposite way. And hits a hit for the Pilots at this point.
That's what they need to do, just get on base. Eventually they'll catch the Foresters slipping and score a single run, maybe.
Here comes the DH now. Urla. He's got himself a single and a double so far. Looking for that triple, trying to climb the ladder. Definitely has the bat to do it. A real strong guy. Ball coming from Wise.
He's getting some like hard pitches. I don't think he might get the triple. I'll just aim for the double.
Urla hasn't had a triple all year. Only has one home run as well, but definitely a big bat to have out there. Wise DH in 333 on the year. Wise has looked very strong, though, in this game. Defensively, also for the Foresters, they've really played a complete game so far. Two-one count. Wise taking his time up on the mound. Runner on first. Ball just outside.
Still some strong pitches. I wouldn't give him nothing easy. At this point of the year, you can't risk anything. One score could lead to 10 other scores.
And that's going to be outside, and Urla going to get walked.
Looks like Colton Punches is in the bullpen. Might see him come in a few pitches, maybe.
We see Coach Frame now going to have himself a mound visit here. I don't think he's going to call, not calling for anyone from the bullpen yet. No outs here. Runners on first and second. Like I said, Wise had himself a great game so far. Like Coach Rain's confidence in the junior. Quick mound visit there from Coach Frame, just trying to slow down the pilots here. Up to bats, Galloway. Galloway hitting 259 on the season.
He's had some big plays this game, hasn't he?
He's made some good defensive plays, definitely. He's done a nice job trying to keep the ball in front of him, really, and as much as he can.
With the hard pitches from Wise, it's kind of hard to get easy ones. Like that.
Say Galloway got struck out swinging in the first and had to fly out later. And his third at bat here, trying to get something going offensively. Second strike there. O-2 count for Tanner Wise, and mound visit seemed to have helped him for the first out here. Try to get him chasing here. And Galloway just getting his bat on it. Going to be a foul. So 0-2 count. Top of the seventh here. Foresters on top 8-0 over the Pilots. The first round of the Crossroads League tournament.
The mound visit gave him some confidence.
Another foul there. See Galloway still battling inside the box.
Trooper. Most people would have just opted to just strike out or just try to get hit by the ball. He's still swinging away at it.
Call for time there from Galloway. Again, runners on first and second. A golden opportunity here for the Pilots with no outs. Really need some runs and need them quickly here in the seventh. And a hit there from Galloway into center. Sees a Pita stopped there as the big arm from Gower. Going to hold the runners here. And base is loaded now for the Pilots. Big hit there from Galloway.
Would you leave him in or would you opt for the pitcher change?
Say you keep Tanner Wise in here. He's had a nice game this whole time. Base is loaded. I think obviously, if there's a hit here, I think you gotta look to your bullpen maybe. So these guys are used to seven innings. Wise, definitely a veteran on this team. Like I said, really has had a nice game so far. Up to bat's McDonald. Himself a single as his first at bat, and we see the pickoff trying to come there, and Erla safe on that.
This Forster team has some tricks up their sleeve for that. Their pickoffs today have been something fantastic.
Say Wise has been great at that, you know, getting the pickoff on second. Really quick turn there. Donald gets the hit. Play made at not made at second. The ball being dropped. That's going to be a run coming in. Zepeda able to get home. So the first run on the board for the Pilots coming off the bat of McDonald.
Now they have really good confidence. The confidence from, like this, the confidence on the slope right now. It started really low in the first, and now in the seventh, it's peaking right now.
Unfortunate play there for the Foresters. Brannick now up to bat. Had himself a single at his last at bat. Once again, no outs. Bases loaded again for the Pilots. Looking to just keep the runners going. Ball a bit high there. And Coach Frame staying with Tanner Wise on the mound. Only giving up one run so far. Looking for the pickoff, not going to be there.
Just a little earlier when he had it.
Sajidiah Phillips come into the game as a pinch runner from McDonald. He's out there on first, was he able to get back in time. Hit going to go foul there from Brannick. Not a bad hit, though. Brings up a 1-2 count, however, for the Pilots.
These ball boys having a field day out here chasing those. You just see them walking around below us. They look upset.
Pitch inside there. 2-2 count.
Question right there. That was a nice pitch.
A bit too inside, it looked like.
You heard the crowd's reaction. They all thought it was a strike.
Wise needs to get himself an out here. Hit through the gap. That's going to score one. They're going to hold the runner at third base, however. And now here comes Coach Frame, and got to think that's going to be it for Tanner Wise. Giving up two runs here in seventh. Back to the top of the lineup now with Foster. We see Wise taking a seat. Looks like probably going to record himself a win, though.
Yep, this late into the game, you might as well chalk it up as a win. I was completely off. It's definitely not Colton Punches. I think it is West.
Coming up here is going to be Tyson Dietrich coming in. Short-term relief guy here. Dietrich, a great pitcher himself. Really has had himself a nice year. 4.6 ERA, however. 3-5 on the mound as a starter. Only pitched 46 innings, though, but really has had himself some strong games as of late and has a really big arm.
Well, with him being a reliever, he doesn't have to pitch that many innings since it's only seven. They're normally used to pitching, like, one, maybe two innings.
Yeah, well, I mean, we've seen Dietrich start a few games here and there. He's been one of the guys coming back off of injury from last season and starting to kind of get form. Once again, late in the season, really saw him coming together. And it's getting one of the biggest guys on the team, you can see. Has a big arm and looking to put this game away for the Foresters as we get to the top of the lineup for the Pilots, and definitely time to go there for Wise. Game had a great game so far, and you know, gotta tip your hat to him.
Yep, he fought all the way through the seventh innings. This is seven tough innings too, because both these teams are really good, but yeah. The Foresters are slightly better today.
You see Dietrich just getting pitches on the mound, getting good, ready to go. But base is going to be loaded for him. Definitely has his work cut out for him here in the seventh. Base is loaded, no outs in the seventh. And Forrest just don't want to let this one get away from him. Yeah, that's going to be the last pitch there for Dietrich. And coming up to bat now, it's going to be Zachary Foster. Two for three at bat here. Got hit by a pitch in the first and a single. And we'll see what he has to offer now. Pilots have been very conservative bringing the runner in from second. We'll see if they don't maybe get a little risky now. It's Dietrich's first pitch is a strike. Got to help his confidence.
This late in the game, you got to risk it all. Might as well take the chance of rounding him from second to home.
So, like I said, the sun back out. Looking nice as Foster going to have a foul there.
You see those hands in the pilot bullpen?
A nice catch there from the dugout, the pilots.
We should record that as an out right there.
Two strikes here. Hit going up the center. Hendricks making the play though to beat him, but Foster going to be out, but a run coming in. Foster doing his job, though.
That was a nice play right there, too. With the ball rolling, he had enough time to pick it up barehanded and just whip it to first. I mean, to get some baseball lessons so I can try this. Intermirez better watch out.
Intermirez. Affolder up to bat here. He's had himself a tough day. Hasn't quite gotten himself on board, but getting a hit here, and that's going to score another run as he's thrown out at first. And so a couple runs coming in for the Pilots. Now we have a runner solely on third with Kelver up to bat.
They're playing it smart, though. I would take the easy out scores instead of grounding fly balls out to center and then pick somebody off at second and first.
Yeah, I mean, the bottom line here with the Pilots, that they're just looking to get runs. Again, all those guys on bases in, and you could afford the outs. You know, you just had to get a hit, put the ball in play, and you're going to score the man from third. And now they've really closed this gap. It was 8-0. Now it's 8-4, halfway back, top of the seventh. Still have two innings after this one. And Kelver up to bat, a good hitter in himself. Definitely, you know, best hitter on the team, hitting 336. Hasn't had himself a hit yet, but looking to get himself going here. Two balls. Make it three balls here. It's Dietrich struggling here against Kelver.
I would hate to see the Foresters lose this game. They played hard from the beginning. And just to see the score slowly go down into one inning just scares me.
There's a strike there from Dietrich. Like I said, you're going to see Kelver here probably take a hit. Up to 3-1 in the count. See, there's the hit there. See, Roser coming over from third and getting Kelver out.
Close play at first.
Very close. But
could have went either way on that one.
Nice job there. Not giving up any more ground from the Foresters. Really did a nice job holding off the Pilots. 8-4. Foresters on top. And just a fantastic job there from Adam Roser coming from third, really cutting off Dylan Hendricks to make that play. And like I said, a very close play it was.
Easy could have went the other way. That's the home field advantage, I think.
Now you have here at Forest Glen Park, the traditional Sweet Caroline being played, a nice ballpark favorite here at Forest Glen, and liked everywhere. In America, it seems to be, you know, a national, almost a national song at any ballpark you go to. See, Wagler still on the mound for the Pilots, who, like we mentioned, really have closed the gap. 8-4, got four runs there in the seventh, and has really brought new life now to them. Starting out this inning, though, for the Foresters is going to be DJ Moore, who's had himself a nice game so far. 2-for-3 on the day. Has two singles.
Standout freshman right there. comes in straight out of high school, makes it look easy with the transition.
Say more coming out of Fort Wayne, Indiana, not too far away from Homestead. Big high school there, and getting himself some action. Not going to make this one, though. It's that one to third base, and Kelver making a nice play.
Very early swing by DJ. If you wait a little bit more, probably would have put it over the head of the third baseman.
Mike Crawley now up to bat. Has a home run and got walked at his last at-bat as well. Remember that a couple innings ago to load the bases. When Wagler first came in, walked Mike Crowley, and already one ball here. That one too low, so 2-0 count for Mike Crowley and the Foresters. Looking to maybe get a few of those hits back, give himself maybe a bigger cushion.
Yeah, because 4 right now, with the way that the Pilots are playing, is not enough.
Pitch inside there. Looks like we might be seeing another walk here on Mike Crowley.
I would, too. The way he's been playing today, I would have walked him every time.
Throwing this ball, you know, everywhere but over the plate. And there's one there for him. It's all strike now, 3-1.
He might have been thinking what we were. He was probably was expecting the walk, too.
Crowley taking a hit, and that's going to be too high. And now sliding down.
Stop.
Play can't be made. Whoa. Crowley going to second, and he's there in time. Wow. What a play there. Affolder just misjudging it. Maybe the wind picking up on that high flyer. Didn't go as far as he thought and couldn't make the play. So Crowley getting himself a double. Going to come out now. TJ Lindstrand in as the courtesy runner.
Off the bat, it looked like it was going to be a fly ball. And then the easy out. Like you said, Indiana weather probably just picked up a wind gust for like 10 seconds and then lost it.
Andy Roser now up to bat for the Foresters. Himself a... two RBIs his last bat with that double. RBI double there. So we'll see what he has coming out with Lindstrand on second. Lindstrand, very good runner, can definitely get in, filling in for the injured Alan Shannon out of the courtesy runner.
See how far away he is?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I say no one even coming close on Lindstrand, give himself a nice lead. Got to think any hit here, you can almost send Lindstrand home. Nice base hit. That ball, though, going to be outside. Now Galloway going to talk to Wagler with it being a 2-0 count. One out here in the seventh inning, and like I said, the Pilots really can't afford to give up any more runs. Down 8-4, Foresters with 12 hits so far on this Saturday afternoon, and looking to advance to that next round in the Crossroads League tournament. They're going to face either Taylor or St. Francis. Lindstrand able to steal third base, and you know, play not even gonna throw the ball to third.
It'll be a waste of time. By the time it got there, probably would have been too late or would have missed, and he would have been home. So better off not risking it at all right there.
2-1 count. One out here in the seventh. Lindstrand sitting on third base. Hit here is going to bring him in. Andy Roser up to bat. Already with a pair of RBIs, looking for another. Gets himself a hit.
That's going to bring him home, though.
Out to left. Lindstrand with the tag going home. And he'll easily make it there. Nice run there from the Foresters. Good job there from Andy Roser getting Lindstrand in. Brock Gower now up to bat. Gower so far 1-for-3. Got himself an RBI though, and looking to take advantage of this lead. He's gonna put a bunt down. Nothing there though. One ball. Two outs here in the seventh. Second pitch just nip in the corner there, the strike zone, and we're going to see a 1-1 count now for Brock Gowers. Wagler doing his best. Nip there from Gower. Wagler done a nice job so far since he's come in. As we see Gower, though, getting a hit.
Finding the big gap right in the outfield.
That's going to bring us to the top of the lineup. Back to Adam Roser. Going to be his fifth at bat. That's how you know the Foresters have really been getting the bats on the balls here tonight.
Five at bats in seven innings. That pros don't even do that. Something special is being done this year. Calling it right now.
Foresters looking to, you know, get some postseason magic here and try to get themselves past this first game, and going to be looking ahead and once again getting the winner of the Cougars and the Trojans will wait. One-oh count here, two outs, man on first. Adam Rosa, third baseman, up to hit. Going to miss that one. One-one count there for Adam Roser. A little bit of delay there as Roser taking his time to get back inside the box. And we see Gower trying to steal second and going to be out by a mile there, thrown out. And that's how the seventh inning will come to a close. Third out coming on Gower trying to steal. Pilots having nothing of it. 9-4, Foresters lead the Pilots in the first round of the Crossroads League Tournament here at Forest Glen Park. I'm Logan Hunt, along with me, joined by Justin Coleman. And this is FDN Sports. We'll be back.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Save 7 cents on every gallon of fuel with the JJ's Excellence Card. Stop in at any JJ store and get yours.
I'm Mike Wanis. I'm the Academic Dean at Huntington University. We are very excited about the Institute for Agricultural Studies and for the new program in agribusiness. Agriculture in Indiana is huge. It's a huge part of the economy. There's a lot of people involved. There's so many different levels of participation from farming all the way up, you know, through all the different kinds of agribusiness. And with our Christian mission, I think that we can bring a unique contribution in that area because we can look at agriculture and we can look at agribusiness, not just as how can we maximize profits, but how are we being good stewards of God's creation? How are we serving humankind, humanity through agriculture. So how can we do that and think about issues of sustainability, issues of justice, and not just about the bottom line?
We're back here, top of the eighth inning. On the mound, still going with Tyson Dietrich. One-one count now. At bat, have Heath Brookshire.
Tyson's doing a really good job coming in with the bases loaded. Only gave up two runs? Was it two runs?
Yeah, just a couple runs there. See, Beecham can't make the play. Brookshire. Oh, they're calling him. They're calling Brookshire out on first. Excuse me, Beecham just getting it to Dietrich in time. And that was definitely close. Umpire calling him out, however.
And the Pirates runner is not having it. He's over there throwing a fit in the dugout.
Yeah, definitely was close there, but nonetheless, good play made by Beecham after bobbling it initially. We have Zapata now up to bat. Zapata with a couple of hits so far. Got shaken up there a couple innings ago out in right field going for a foul ball. Jamar Weaver, but couldn't, you know, hurt his foot a little bit, stayed in the game, and seemed to be okay as we see a shot taken to the Bethel dugout.
That's not a good thing to see.
Foul ball. Just
line drive.
Yeah, line drive there. Everyone looks to be all right. Looks like ball safely made it through. And now Zapata going to be struck out here by Dietrich.
Going to go say sorry to his teammates for the near-death experience right there.
Two up, two down so far in the eighth for Dietrich. 9-4 lead for the Foresters. Erla up to bat. Has a single and a double and was walked at his last at bat. Pitch right down the gut. Erla not going to take a swing at it. Going to be a strike. Just a reminder that the winner of this game is going to take on the winner of the Trojans and the Cougars. As we see Erla being thrown out at first, and now we'll retire the runners there. And we'll see the change overcome with that being the third out. But the winner getting the winner of Taylor and St. Francis, and through three so far, the Trojans with a 4-0 lead over the Cougars. So looking like Taylor, the top team in the CrossFit League, taking care of business so far against the Cougars. And the Foresters could have themselves another date with the Trojans on Monday.
The way they're playing right now, we can hope that the Forester guys right now go as far as the girls did.
Yeah, definitely. HU softball playing in a championship game down at Indianapolis, taking on Marion University in the double elimination style tournament. So far, the Foresters haven't lost in that tournament. If they beat Marion, which is going on right now, which the last update we had was just top of the second. Marion was up 1-0 over the Foresters. Now, if the Foresters can win that game, they will win the CrossFit League and advance to Nationals. Now, if they lose to Marion in this first matchup, then Marion has to beat them again since it is a double elimination tournament. Marion already with one loss, Foresters with none. So once again, if HU softball can win this first game, they'll go to Nationals and win the tournament. Now, if they lose, they get a second chance to try to clinch it. So good luck to the Foresters down in Indianapolis looking to bring home some hardware.
Be nice to have a trophy case. Always nice to have a new trophy.
Yeah, and you know, just the fact of that, Brock Gower on the baseball team here, father, Coach Gower, is actually the coach of the softball team, so baseball and softball running thick in that blood. Coming up now for the Foresters, Adam Roser, leadoff. Gonna lead off here the eighth inning. Foresters with the 5-run advantage so far. And looking to stay in front of the Pilots.
Only got to hold them off for another inning.
Rosa now with the clean slate. After Gower got thrown out trying to steal at second. And Rosa taking the first pitch and taking a deep right, but going to be caught by Zapata for the first out.
Line drive straight to him. He barely had to move. He took a single step, and it was in his hand.
Like I said, that was Rosa's fifth at bat. Another at bat now coming for Jamar Weaver. Having a great day so far. Three hits, two singles and a double, and got walked in the first inning. Saw Weaver show bunt. Not a good throw, though. Going to be a ball. Hit there. Going to split through the third baseman and shortstop. And Weaver again with another hit. Get himself another single.
He might need to check his bet. I think he waited. It's waited over there. Everything's finding a way to get the hit. So next break we take, I'm going to go check his bet.
See Beecham coming up now. Himself a double and a solo home run. Pass two, though. Hadn't quite got enough underneath it. 2 for 4 on the day and looking to keep it going. One out, runner on first. Ball going to be inside.
The Foresters might as well just play it safe. I wouldn't steal anymore. Honestly, at this point in the game, might as well just leave everybody ready on base.
Remember last year in the conference tournament, Foresters making it almost to the championship game, got to the semifinals, ended up losing to Spring Arbor. Definitely a tough loss there for the Foresters. Felt like let one get away here at their home field, and Spring Arbor really took advantage of it and had some really nice pitching and really good games, and Foresters just couldn't quite get it done and really been trying to play with that sort of revenge coming in to this season. See a nice pitch there from Wagler, able to get it down to the strike zone.
That was a nasty ball right there.
Nice curveball coming down on him. 1-2 count. Beach taking a hit. Shot's going to make it through. And we'll advance Weaver to second. Shea Beach with another hit.
When you're the coach of this team, you might as well just be a happy camper today. Not everything's going the way you wanted it to. Literally, you can just sit back and relax and watch baseball.
Now we'll see Dan Wiltshire coming in for Shea Beecham. He's going to run for him on first and give Beecham a bit of a break. First time we've seen Dan Wiltshire tonight. Dalton Combs up to bat. Got hit by a pitch last time up. Looking to get himself a hit here. See Wagler keeping the runners on. It's getting them back.
Isn't that really close to a buck?
I didn't actually throw the ball there or anything, so.
Okay.
He's allowed to step off after that.
I would have ripped that boy for a home run right there. It was right in the city, too.
Hey, look at the little slow coming through there, but Combs electing not to hit. Saw something a little different. One strike there. Combs getting a rip on that one. That's going back to the wall. Ooh. Off the wall. Here comes Weaver going home. Wiltshire rounding third. And Combs getting himself a double.
Like wow. I said, I would have ripped it for a home run.
Big hit there from Combs. Oh, getting about halfway through the wall and needed that wall to be a little lower. Would have had himself a home run.
He picked the worst spot to hit it to. If you put it a little to the left, or at least center field, he would have had a home run. Would that be his second of the day or would it be his first one?
It'd be his first home run. He had a triple earlier.
The bats of the Foresters today. Oh, my. I feel like pro teams would be can't hit like this.
Yeah, every so often in baseball, you just kind of have a day like this, and going well for the Foresters up 10-4 now. Scoring Jamar Weaver and Dylan Hendricks up to bat. Runners on second and third. The hit from Combs, and only one out. Top or in the bottom of the eighth.
Gotta love baseball this deep into the school year, especially right before finals week.
We see Hendricks gonna get thrown out at first, but gonna score Dan Wiltshire. Hendricks doing his job and bringing someone in. We've seen him do that multiple times. It's gonna be his third RBI of the day.
This is teamwork right here. Teamwork gets you this far into the postseason. And especially getting you this. Look at the score. This is teamwork at its best right here. 10-4 in the bottom of the eighth.
11-4 now off the run from Wiltshire.
Whoops, I'm sorry about that.
16 hits, though, by the Foresters. And like I said, sometimes the bats are hot, and the Foresters really just coming to play today. being at home, they're good to go. And up to bat, it's DJ Moore. It was thrown around a little bit. Wasn't anticipating already being back up. That's why it was a bit of a delay there.
Well then, I forgot he was even up to bat. Didn't think we got through the order that quick.
DJ Moore, 2-for-4 on the day, pair of singles. Looking to bring in Dalton Combs and slides one in the gap out to the right, gives himself another single and brings in Combs off the first pitch.
This is not deja vu, people. This is the second time you've seen him in one inning. This is how we play baseball here at Huntington.
So now, just like that, Jake Hansen now coming in to bat. See a change in the lineup. Jake Hansen now getting into the game for Mike Crowley. So I'm sure we'll see Andy Roser move over to the catching spot when the time comes. Hansen with his first at bat. Another freshman who's had himself a nice year gets a hit. That's going to go foul.
This has been a long eighth inning. It feels like it's been an entire game just for this one inning.
Going back to Jake Hansen, the freshman, started a couple of games, played in 30 games, started 27 of them, hitting about 210 on the year, and started out pretty hot, got himself good hits and got himself in the line, then got himself hurt in a game and had to come out, and hasn't been the same since, but still getting some good quality minutes, good playing time as a freshman. We've seen him, DJ Moore, and Adam Roser all really get a lot of good minutes.
Is Blake still on the team? Is that?
Yeah, he was hurt, though.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. He got Tommy John?
Yeah, he was rumored to be possibly a closer for the Foresters, but got hurt earlier on the season. Not going to have him for this year. But a bright future for the Foresters, especially in the pitching department with him, and also Dax McLaughlin, another freshman, has got himself some good time. And we see Hansen rip one out to center field, and that's going to bring DJ Moore all the way around. They're going to send him home. And Moore is going to get in, scoring from first. And Hansen gives himself an RBI double.
Wow. Yep. I'm definitely checking their bats after this. Something's not right here. Can't do it.
Well, how about that for Hansen coming up and doing that? I like seeing that for the Foresters now. Just when you were sweating it just a little bit after the seventh inning, Forster's answered with a run. It was 8-4 and got himself to 9-4. Nice bit of pitching from Tyson Dietrich, and now they're starting to lay it on again here in the eighth, up 13-4 off of 18 hits.
Wow. I'm speechless, honestly. I don't know what to say about this. But the Forces deserve this after, like, the year they've had. We've had a lot of injuries. We've lost pitchers due to other injuries. So a game like this is what they needed to start the playoffs.
Sitting on two outs here. Andy Roser up to bat. Has Hansen on second. Another ball wide outside. Two straight balls coming from Wagler. Just past the two-hour mark on this game. It's past 5 o'clock, and Forster's rolling so far. Roser getting a hit. Looks maybe a bit too high. Is going to come back in.
Is the wind going to catch it again?
Affolter making sure he gets his glove under that one, and that is how the eighth inning will end, with the Foresters going in to the last inning, up 13-4 over the Bethel College Pilots. We'll be back with the final inning here at Forest Glen Park when we return to FDN Sports.
I'm Mike Frame. I'm the head baseball coach here at Huntington University. This is my 31st year here at the university. We feel like that we have a tradition, a reputation of doing things the right way. We really place a high emphasis on commitment, personal responsibility, playing the game the right way, work ethic, Those things are all really important in our program. We're looking for those guys that really want to come to Huntington University and be challenged in the classroom, be challenged with their faith in Christ and growing in that part of their life, and place a high value on their baseball development, wanting to be a part of a program that's special. And that's what we try to work at every day.
Welcome back to Forest Glen Park, where we see Tyson Dietrich looking to finish this game out for the Foresters on the mound. Tanner Wise, when he got pulled, was, you know, had the lead 8-2, and so far now 13-4. See Wise probably gonna give himself a win, and Dietrich coming in and really taking care of business. The Pilots, though, looking to try to get some runs. They're gonna need a really big last inning, but Foresters really just kind of putting this one almost out of reach after that eighth inning.
Yes, that eighth inning was something magical for the Foresters. You heard it from the crowd, too. You hear little murmurs from down there. Oh, this is something crazy. 18 hits, 13. Wow. Literally almost every hit has scored.
Yeah, it's been definitely a nice hitting display here. And like I said, sometimes it's your day. And today the Foresters are, you know, making ends meet, and they're going to look to play Monday afternoon at 3:30. They're going to probably take on the winner of Taylor and St. Francis. Like I mentioned, last score update that we had here was Taylor was up 4-0 on St. Francis. And also a softball update with the Lady Foresters losing the first game 5-0 to Marion. Second match for the Crossroads League title will be coming in just a few minutes down in Indianapolis. So wishing the best of luck to the ladies, dropping a hard first game, but get to redeem themselves maybe in the second matchup. And an all-or-nothing game, that's what you live for, and we'll see if the ladies can't get it done and get themselves an invite to the national championship, or to nationals.
You got to have faith in the Foresters, so that's what we preach at this school here. Literally every game comes down to the last pitch, and you never know.
I say, ladies looking to take care of business, and with Marion winning the regular season title, I believe they might actually go already to nationals being that next place team. So we'll see about that. Ladies just going to look to bring home the Crossroads League title and should be going to nationals. As congratulations to them and nice, and Coach Garrett and everything they've done. Hit coming from McDonald, that's going to be up in the air and going to be fielded by Combs for the second out.
One more out. Foresters can chalk this one up as a win.
Say definitely, it's been a good game so far from the Foresters, and really have definitely played to their strengths, to say the least. So we have Brannick coming up as could be the last pitcher, and we see him taking a whack at it, and Combs making the grab, and the Foresters gonna take the first game here in the Crossroads League tournament. Able to take down the Bethel College Pilots 13-4. And like you mentioned, Justin, off 18 hits. Really just a great win all around for the Foresters.
Yep, everything about this team today was fantastic. Fielding, pitching, batting for sure. So they might as well have walked out with the win.
Yeah, big win for them. They're going to play at 3:30 on Monday. That's right, 3:30 on Monday. They are going to travel to Taylor University, now the home site for the rest of the tournament, with Taylor winning the Crossroads League title. They earned home field advantage. And so the Force is going to be taking on either the Trojans of Taylor University or the Cougars of St. Francis. Like we mentioned, the last update we had, Taylor was up 4-0 on the Cougars. So best of luck to Huntington University men's baseball, as they're going to look to really get a deep run into this tournament.
Yep, good luck to both teams. Hope to see you all in the finals.
Well, the Foresters are now 20-26 on the year, extending their conference record to 15-10 as well. Really turned it on to conference time, and big win for them. And once again, they're going to play Monday at 3:30, getting the winner of Taylor University and St. Francis University. And as for us here at FDN Sports, our first live stream baseball event. Just a things, you know, a bright future to come here at Forest Glen Park. Gonna have a even nicer broadcast coming next year. Going to have multiple cameras and really looking to upgrade the broadcast even more. Just a glimpse of what's to come.
It's going to look like a basketball game, I agree. Like, our basketball games aren't going to be nothing compared to this.
Well, we have to thank everyone who's been a part of this broadcast, from our director, Derek Zerker, to our producer, Jake Cross. Also, our cameraman, Brian, doing a great job as well. As for myself, Logan Hunt, and Justin Coleman, we are signing out here at FDN Sports for the last time this year. And finals week coming up, and we're ready to be out. But from all of us here at FDN Sports, I wish you all a very happy Saturday.